Hi, so pretty interesting day in the world of Omarchy. They dropped a 9 o'clock this morning, they dropped a big update, 3.1. I think we were on version 3.02 beforehand. So I was just having a look at Discord, and there's like a lot of people rumbling around on there with things changed. And so I just thought I'd just do a quick have a look at what's changed, what's been updated. It's not huge, but it did throw a few people. But all the changes are for the good, I think. Anyway, so with that in mind, let's dive in. Okay, so here we are in Omarchy as usual. And basically, if you head on over to, if you've done an update today on Omarchy, you'd note that there was quite a big update, and then you may have had something about elephants or something or other. So they changed certain elements. Anyway, it's all here on GitHub. If you Google it or whatever, I'll put the link to GitHub in the bottom. And so there's a newer install ISO as well. So anyway, very quickly, what they've done is they've changed a lot of the key bindings, which have thrown a few people. But they're actually really intelligent changes, because I could never work out why, you know, something like the, you know, super F was basically files, which sounds great, but it really should be, you know, full screen, which is what I think happens on Hyprland on other installations when you configure it. But now it is full screen. So what's happened is a lot of those sort of the keys have transferred. They've got the shift has been added. So if I just go into a new window, so I've got one of my keys programmed for DaVinci Resolve, which was shift D, but it was super D, nothing happens. So I'm sure there was a lot of people like going super, all you need to do now is add the shift. So if I go super shift D, he says, yeah, up comes Resolve. So I went through and I checked just a lot of the stuff. Let's get rid of that. But everything like super W is still the same. But if you wanted to get btops up, you would have done super T, but now it's super shift T. So it brings up btops. And then you can just go super F and go full screen, which is great because it was on F11 for some reason before, but it's not now. So just if you press super F again, then you go back to normal. So let's just jump back to workspace one. So that's been, you see it here. And the other one that I found really weird was copy and paste, because it used to be super shift C, I think, and super C, and it was just used to throw me. So now it's just super C and super V. So that sort of is, you know, works better in my brain. And then also now the clipboard manager has been changed to, as you can see on the screen here, it's gone to super F, full screens now 11, super T, and then super return still stays as terminal. But they've added these changes, these tweaks. Now, what would have happened if you go into here and you go, hang on a minute, setup, key bindings. And it launches your key bindings. For me, it launches Kate. You can see that you've now got super shift. If you go back and look at your old key bindings, which they've still kept, so that is, hang on, I've got to remember, it's a super shift F now for file browser. If you go back into your config, go back into your config file, he says, looking down, where are you? Config. And then you've got Hyprland. Somewhere in here, he says you can't spell HH, hyper. And then you've got the old bindings are here in a back file. So if I open that up, open with, what have we got? Where's Kate gone? Open with Kate. Open. Pops up here, so I've got two windows open. So that's my new bindings, which is everything's got super shift on. Old bindings, you've only got super shift B browser, super T activity, super D Docker. Now my super D opens Resolve. Everything got like an uplift. So if we go over here, so super shift E opens email, super shift Y equals YouTube. That may, you know, it's only a small shift, but I think it threw a lot of people stabbing the keyboard, trying to remember where things were. Anyway, so the keyboard shift was interesting, but you can go back. You're not tied to it. And it's just bizarre. Like yesterday, if you look at my channel, I actually released an app that backs up your config files, because I think some people have made modifications to their system as well. And this sort of messed that up. So if you look at the previous video, I'll put a link in the top there. I wrote an app, a TUI, that basically backs up your config file. because I think a lot of people are like going back and they're discovering this, what I did when I trashed my system, that if you go back to, if you do a snapshot restore, you don't get your configs back. So that app, you know, it was just bizarre that I've written it. I wrote it the day before they dropped this. Nobody's going, my config's gone, or this has changed. What's happened? So use the app if you want, and you can store your config as of today. You can fiddle around the next time they do this, they change the key bindings. You can just restore everything how it was beforehand, because the underlying engine's not changed. And it was really smart, because I was trying to build it into this, which is the, it's called Walker, which they've totally upgraded the back end of this Walker thing, which is basically the menu application. I was trying to get it built into it. My version was going to go sit underneath Shutdown, but the Red Pill app now sits in Red there. So now my little app now sits in here, because it was too dangerous to do it into the menu. It just wouldn't work. Anyway, let's come out of that. So there you go. So that's, let's get rid of those. So that's sort of like key bindings and everything like that. So that's their own stuff. But some other bits they've added, which is really nice. I'll get to it. There's a really nice, so they've got a whole thing here about the super CV, the super key with copy and paste, which is great because it threw me a little bit. Now you can group your tilings, but the one that I liked, they've also got a theming, live theming of Obsidian. So they've sort of built into Obsidian as well. So if you use Obsidian Notes, and let's go Obsidian. Now, Obsidian should launch, he says, and it should be themed. So select Omarchy under themes appearance, themes in Obsidian, and you could change them. So let's try that. Let's just try a theme change. So style, themes. Let's just change it to Cappuccino Latte. There you go. So now that's changed my theme. So let's go back in there again. Start, just change back to Tokyo, theme back to Tokyo Night. And there you go. So everything sort of matches up. They're giving you a way to sort of, I know that DHH is obsessed with how things look, fair play. I love it. I'm not knocking it. It's great when everything matches. And then more to do with themes as well. They've given you this. Let me just get rid of this screen. Actually, let's get a new one. They've given you, just get a different wallpaper up. Well, I think we'll have that one. Okay, so now they've also given you an app called AETHER, which allows you to sort of create your own color palettes and themes. I'll show you how that works. So select an image. When I go into here, I've got this picture. Okay, I'll open it. These brilliant, I think it's MJ26, the Japanese company or something. And then you can extract all the colors to create a palette. And from that palette, I haven't played with this too much, but this looks a great font. And then you can apply as a theme. And there's my theme. So now I've got my own theme that I've just done off that thing. Let me have a look. So hang on, let's get out of that. Super W. So now my theme's changed. So let's just launch Obsidian again. See if that's come up with my blue theme. No? Well, maybe if you don't like this then. I did see it go blue. What's that change then? Let's do the browser. My browser's changed, but Obsidian's not picked up on that yet. But that's really cool. So you can literally willy-nilly sort of, let's just go back into that again. Pick a picture, pick a palette, and apply it to match your background. That's really nice. Also, I think they fixed the calculator, because if you remember, the calculator used to be gigantic, but that's now changed. So now it fits. So let's get rid of that. Let's go back to my, not like that one. Oh, look, btop has changed color. Okay, let's go back to Super Shift B. And let's just go back to the Git. I've got a Git thing here. All bookmarks, bookmark panel, and there we are. Let's go back in. So lots of sort of like, there's a new theme as well. There's lots of like extra little changes. There's a flex, so I don't compromise that theme as well. There's some stuff for VMs. But yeah, no, the keyboard thing, I think for everybody, there was a few problems. It was this, it was all to do with Walker, which is this sort of menu system here. Now mine's rethemed with my blue theme. But that's really nice. So yeah, so let's go back to full screen. forgotten what workspace meant. I'm in that one. Escape. Let's go back to full screen. So I'll talk to you. Yeah, so there you go. So bit of an update, 3.1. It's the one you did the ISO. If you're going to install it, it's the ISO. There's some other stuff in there. If you read through what's in the Git update, they've made some tweaks. There's lots of stuff behind the scenes as well, sort of like stuff to do with modem, Ethernet, Wi-Fi, bits and bobs like that. But no, great. I mean, there was a few people that had issues. So I think the thing is, it's like, as I was talking about this in my other video, you're going to play, aren't you? You're going to play. You've been given a Rice Linux distribution. You're going to start to play with Hyprland, and then things are going to change because they've got to go back to a default one where they do an update, or they, you know, they've got to have a baseline. So yeah, so if you want that app, I've written it. If someone can help me get it onto GitHub as some kind of pull or something, whatever they call it, all it does, it backs up your config files and just puts them in a zip, and then you can restore them. So you can just, like, you know, play to your heart's content and do it. I don't know how Git works. I make videos. Do you know what I mean? I edit commercials. I have no idea how that stuff works, but it's there if you want it. But no, all in all, great little update. Unexpected on a Sunday. When I did the update, update window, it started to do stuff, and I thought, hang on a minute, what's going on here? And there's quite a lot. I didn't even miss, there's a spinning icon at the top here of the screen that's supposed to tell you to do the update. But yeah, no, I mean, sure, there's other tiny little things I'll notice, but the system's working great. It's super quick, you know. The only thing that I need to know is this happens. Let me just go over it. Let's just go to a new screen. Let's just go back out of this into scene two, and I'll show you the only thing that I need. Let's go there. This is the only thing that needs to work for me. If that window comes up, I'm done. Anyway, there you go. Omarchy 3.1, great little update. I hope you work it out. Have a look on Discord. Have a look on GitHub. You'll find out what you need to find out if it's broken for you. Anyway, thanks for watching.